Chapter 3, Fiber to Fabric, Class 7th. The material used for clothing vary around the world. Some textiles are better suited to a particular climate. In cold climates, people wear warm garments made up of wool or closely woven fabrics. These materials are usually good insulators of heat because they trap air. In hot climates, people prefer to wear white or light-colored clothes because such colors absorb very little heat. People of the Arabian desert wear loose, flowing garments that shield their bodies from the blazing sun. The same garments protect them against the cold night air. In temperate regions, people wear different types of clothing because of four different seasons: summer, spring, autumn, and winter. Their types of clothes vary with each different seasons. Thus, people wear clothes made from different fibers for protection against several kinds of weather. Fibers. Fiber is the starting point of the textile chain. Fiber is spun into yarn. The yarn is woven or knitted into fabrics, which are then used to make finished products such as clothes, tablecloths, and bags. We know that natural fibers are of two types: plant fiber and animal fibers. Vegetable fibers or plant fibers are thread-like filaments and structural material, that is, cellulose of plants. They are obtained from various parts of the plant. We shall now discuss animal fiber in detail. Animal fibers are made up of proteins. Wool and silk are two natural fibers obtained from animals. Wool. During the winters, we wear woolen clothes. Do you know where we obtain wool from? Wool is a fiber obtained from the fleece or hair of some animals. Wool is soft to touch and provides warmth. Wool fibers trap air in the spaces present. Since air is a poor conductor of heat, the fiber keeps us warm. Wool fiber can be easily dyed in different colors. Animals yielding wool. Wool fibers are obtained from sheep, goat, angora rabbits, goats, alpaca, and even camels. Sheep. Most sheep have two types of hair from which the wool is obtained. The outer corus hair is known as kemp. The fine, soft undercoat close to the skin is true wool, from which the wool fiber is obtained. Domestication and selective breeding have eliminated most of the long hair. These sheep are covered almost exclusively with the true wool. Kashmiri goat. The fine, soft fiber obtained from the undercoat of Kashmiri goat is called Kashmir. The outer coat fiber are quite coarse, and high quality Kashmir is obtained by dehairing, or Kashmir goat are found only in the mountain regions of China and Tibet. Angora rabbit. Soft white fiber called angora wool is obtained from the angora rabbit. Stiff, long guard hair growing through the soft coat have to be removed before the fur from these rabbits are combed out. The soft white fur obtained is then spun into yarn that is used to make sweaters. Yak. Yak are found in Tibet and Ladakh. Their coats consist of outer long coarse hair and an undercoat of soft and silky wool. The color usually ranges from brown to black. Camel. Camel fleece consists of a soft, fine undercoat and an overcoat of long coarse hair that grows up to 15 inches long. Camel wool is considered a healthy natural product. It has an excellent thermal insulation property. Sheep farming. Sheep farming means rearing and breeding sheep. Sheep are reared mainly for their wool. They are reared in herds in arid, semi-arid, and mountainous regions. In India, sheep are reared in Rajasthan, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. They mainly feed on grass. They are also fed on with the mixtures of pulses, corns, dry grass, and grains. Common breeds of Indian sheep are Lohi, Rajpushire, Nali, Bakharwal, Marwadi, and Pathanwadi. Shearing and processing wool. The steps involved in wool production are follows. Shearing. The process of removal of woolen coat or fleece from the animal is called shearing. This is done without harming the animal by using shearing tools such as scissors, hand blades, and electric shears. It is usually done during the hot season. This allows them to grow back hair by time arrives. The amount of wool produced by one sheep varies from 1 to 3 kg. Scoring. Wool taken directly from the sheep is called raw or grease wool. It contains sand, dirt, grease, vegetables, dried sweat, and requires thorough cleaning. Therefore, to make the wool suitable for making fabric, it is scored. Scoring involves washing the strong wool into hot water and detergent and then drying, sorting, and grading. After scoring, the damaged or the inferior wool is removed. This process is called sorting. The process of sorting the wool according to the length, color, and texture of fibers is called grading. Carding. Before wool can be used for making fabric, it is tangled and cleaned. The intermixed fibers are separated to form continuous fibers. This process is called carding. In carding, the wool fibers are passed through the series of metal teeth fibers, making yarn. Carded wool is twisted into a rope called silver. The silver is stretched and twisted into a thin yarn. Spinning for woolen yarns is typically done on a mule spinning machine. Weaving and finishing. Woolen yarn is woven or knitted into fabric, which is then used to make finished product such as clothes, tables, clothes, and bags. Properties and quality of wool. Durability. Wool is hard fiber that retain a night's appearance for a long time. Absorption of moisture. As a fabric, wool draw moisture from the body or and absorb it inside its fibers. Heat is generated as moisture is absorbed so that garments stay warm without feeling wet. Resistance to dirt. Wool fibers have an outer layer of scales that reduce the ability of dirt and dust to penetrate the fiber. Resistance to fire. Once the properties of wool is dead, it does not burn easily. When subjected to flames, it will smolder instead. Water repellent in nature. Even though wool absorbs moisture, the scale of the outer layer of each fiber repel liquids. Insulating nature. Tiny gaps are present between the fibers. These are filled with bubbles of air, which heat up as the moisture in the center of the fiber heats up, making the wool a perfect insulator. The quality of wool is judged by the wool length, diameter, elasticity, strength, and durability, effectiveness as an insulator, and its ability to take up clearing dyes. Silk. Silk is a valuable fabric that symbolizes wealth and prosperity. In earlier times, use of silk was reserved only for kings and monarchs. The Romans sold silk for its weight in gold. The Chinese have been using silk since 7th century BC. China is credited with the first production of silk at around 3000 BCE. Silk is an animal fiber made from the cocoon of silkworm. A large number of these cocoons are unwound carefully to make long threads. These threads are spun together to make them thicker and then woven to make silk. The production of raw silk by raising silkworm is known as sericulture. Life cycle of silk moth. Silk moth is a large white insect. The different stages in the life cycle of silk moth are shown. Egg. Egg is the first stage of silkworm life cycle. The female moth lays its eggs during the summer. The egg hatches in spring. Larva. The egg hatch into larvae or caterpillars which feed on tender mulberry leaves. This stage lasts for about 27 days, and during this time, the larvae shed their skin 4 times. The process of shedding the skin is known as molting. Pupa. The caterpillar spins fine silk filaments around it in layers to form cocoon. The silkworm takes 3 to 7 days to prepare the cocoon. The silk thread are obtained from the cocoon. The color of the cocoon can range from white to golden yellow. Silk moth. The pupa changes into moth which comes out of the cocoon. The female adult lays eggs and the cycle continues. Processing of silk. The cocoons are obtained before the larvae matures by dipping the cocoon in hot water. The process of obtaining silk threads by soaking cocoons in hot water is called reeling or filleter. Filaments. From 4 to 8 cocoons are separated and slightly twisted to create a single strand. Many strands together constitute a silk yarn. These strands are then spun into silk cloth by the weavers. Properties and quality of silk. It is soft, smooth, and lustrous. It is the strongest natural fiber. It absorbs moisture readily. It is cool to wear in summer and warm to use in the winter. It can be easily dyed in any color. The quality of silk fabric depends on many factors such as the type of silkworm, quality of mulberry leaves fed to the silkworms, a selection of cocoons, and weaving and finishing of silk thread. Let us see how natural wool and silk fibers can be differentiated from synthetic fibers by performing a flame test. Activity: to differentiate natural wool and silk fiber from synthetic and or artificial fibers. Materials required: small sample of nylon, silk, wool fabric, Bunsen burner, and a tong. Procedure involved: hold the fabrics one by one over the flame by the forceps, which sample melts, ignites, and curls. Now touch the fiber at to the tip of the flame. Does it ignite quickly or slowly? Remove the fiber from the flame. Does it self-extinguish, continue to burn, or continue to glow? Describe the order given off. Does it smell burning hair, or does it smell like a burning plastic? Blow the flame out. Allow the fabric to cool. Press the residue between your fingers. It is hard or powdery. Describe the ash quality that remains. On the basis of these observations, try to know the properties of wool, silk, and synthetic fibers. Thank you.